how's your day going?
Pretty awesome. Yep. Hey, I have a new case of COVID that I want to run past you. Do you have a second?
Yeah, shoot.
Okay. So the health department alerted me today that our student Ima be all right. She tested positive on the 4th. They hadn't been able to get a hold of the parents, so I called this morning and I talked to mom.
Oh, how's Ima feeling?
Mom said she's actually doing pretty well. She has a cough, she's really tired, but otherwise she's okay and improving.
Oh, glad to hear that. When did she first start feeling sick?
So I asked mom and she said that Ima had a very mild, really mild runny nose and a small headache on the 1st, but she'd been playing outside, weather change, all that, you know, and she'd helped mow the lawn. So they figured it was allergies because she gets allergies every year at this time. So they actually sent her to school on the 2nd and the 3rd. And on the night of the 3rd, she started coughing. So mom took her in to get tested on the 4th and it was positive.
Yeah, we've been seeing that a lot of the symptoms that we've seen are really, really mild and kind of difficult to tell.
Yeah, often seems just like a cold or even just a little bit of nausea. So hard to know the difference, but it can be really tricky to tell the difference between COVID and allergies or a cold. So it's really important that people who are having those symptoms get tested right away.
Here's Molly here with a little more information on COVID symptoms. The following symptoms are in category number 1, where if you only have one of these symptoms, you need to stay home and get tested for COVID. They include a fever above 100 degrees, a cough, difficulty breathing or shortness of breath, a new loss of taste or smell, a sore throat, muscle or body aches, vomiting, and diarrhea. In the following category, you need 2 of these symptoms, or if you have 2 of these symptoms, then you need to stay home and get tested for COVID. They are headache, fatigue, runny nose or nasal congestion, and nausea. And now a little bit of information on how we count your 10 days of quarantine. So, the day that you first feel symptoms is day 0. We then count forward 10 days. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And you can return to school on the 11th day as long as symptoms are resolving and you've been fever-free for 24 hours.
So if Ima first became symptomatic all the way back on the 1st, then she can return after 10 days, assuming that she doesn't have any more symptoms and she's been fever-free for 24 hours.
Right.
So if we count the first day of symptoms as day 0, then we count forward 10 days. She can return on the 11th day. So that means she can come back on the 12th.
Right. Yeah. Okay. Good counting. Okay. So I will send that information about her return date to her school so they can track it for attendance.
Great. And while you do that, I'll see if her principal and teacher can join us to talk about contact tracing.
Okay, excellent plan.
All right, thanks for joining us. We know you're swamped and we really appreciate how the teachers and administrators prioritize the health and safety of all of our students.
I'm glad to be here.
Yes, we're glad to be here. Thank you.
Awesome, okay, so here's the situation. Our student, Ima Be All Right, she tested positive on the 4th, and we need to do her contact tracing. Unfortunately, she attended school while she was symptomatic because her symptoms were really mild. So we need to think through close contacts for the 2 days before she had the runny nose and headache, and then the days after when she was cool.
It's Nurse Molly again. So just a reminder that 2 days before you become symptomatic are those really contagious days where we can be unknowingly spreading these germs to other people. So parents and guardians, that's why it's very important to watch your child for these symptoms and to respond to even mild symptoms, because these mild symptoms often end up being COVID even when we thought it was just a cold.
That's a lot of days.
Yeah, Ima gave us an idea of her close contacts at lunch, so that's a start.
Mrs. McGarry, can you please send me a list of all the close contacts in your classroom? That would be anyone that's under 3 feet in distance, but over 15 minutes cumulatively.
Will do.
I'll also look into those close contacts at lunch, on the bus, with the specials teachers as well, the best we can.
Great. Excellent plan, everyone. Once we have that list of close contacts, Mrs. Skinner can notify the parents.
I'll also send the notices to the classroom and to the building about the positive case.
All right. Principal Skinner and Mrs. McGarry, if you have any close contacts you're unsure of, let us know and I'll run it past the health department. We're following the Ohio Department of Health guidelines very closely, and our local health department helps us think through cases that aren't super clear. I really trust them to make the hard calls.
Oh, the staff at the Athens City County Health Department, they're my heroes.
Oh, mine too.
Me too.
Me too.
So grateful for them. Okay, Mrs. Skinner, Mrs. McGarry, thanks again for fitting this in between the millions of other things that you have on your plate today. You do so, so much, as do all the administrators and all the teachers and all the staff, to keep our school community safe. Let's hope we don't have any more cases at your building today.
Thank you.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
Okay, anything else I'm forgetting?
Once we get the list, I'll notify the health department and Dr. Gibbs about the positive case and the close contacts.
Cool. I'll update the dashboard by the end of the day.
And now a little bit of information on how we update the dashboard. So at the end of every day, Nurse Heidi and I update the dashboard on the Athens City Schools website. This is categorized by building and then per staff and students within that building. On the dashboard, we list only positive cases of COVID-19. That does not include people who were quarantined due to being close contacts. And FYI, the sixth graders at the Plains Intermediate School, because this year they are housed at the middle school building, we are including them in the middle school's count on the dashboard.
Okay, I'm going to check my email here. You want to do yours too?
Molly?
Yeah?
The high school just forwarded an email. One family, four cases, all of them at school yesterday.
Okay, okay. We got this. Yeah. I mean, with our amazing staff and the support of the Athens City County Health Department, Heidi, we can do anything.
Anything?
Oh, anything. Go team.